If you like, you can, otherwise go. Well, I don't like. But I must say that the real thing. If you want unadulterated thing, then come in. And if you want mixed husband, go and do it. We cannot make any compromise with husband.
All right, Hare Krishna. Please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. So I'm here at the Suntec City Convention Center. We're having a four-day book distribution service here. There's a trade fair that's going on. And the fun fact is that Gaur Gopal Das is going to come here tomorrow as the celebrity and give some speech here. But of course, as we know, he will not speak anything Krishna conscious. He will just talk some mundane motivational stuff. So this is the result of getting into the trap of jana. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, na dhanam, na janam, na sundarim. So three things that he doesn't want, money, adoration or fame, beautiful women. But that's what he's after, you see, because he's after this intoxication of following or adoration. You see, he has compromised so much, he doesn't speak anything about Krishna at all. And then that's what's going to happen tomorrow as well. That's a novelty here.
Madharam madhuram vadanam madhuram nayanam madhuram hasitam
This is the end of day two at this Singapore International Indian Expo, 2019 January. So tomorrow morning 10 a.m. we have a kirtan on the stage, and tomorrow 6 p.m. Gaur Gopal is speaking at a hall just adjacent to this hall. That's his poster. I won't even be able to go in because it's a ticketed event. It's a $40 per person ticket, and then he's distributing his book, which is Life's Amazing Secrets. He's just making a brand of his own. And nothing to do with Krishna consciousness at all. It's just going on his own tangent. Everybody's asking me, in fact, you know, oh, you're Gaur Gopal. I said, it's not my Gaur Gopal. I don't agree with him at all. So I'm excited more about the kirtan. So actually, I want to make a video, the kirtan that we do and then preaching that Gaur Gopal does. You know, there's a comparison of where we are heading in terms of following Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada said no compromise. So that should be the principle of us devotees. We can't compromise.
So this kirtan is the congregational singing of the Lord's holy names. In fact, it is the most purest form of all religion. In fact, every religion has the name of God and they recommend to chant it. So we also chant like that, Hare Krishna. So there is a nice shloka in the Srimad Bhagavatam which says, Tasmat Sankirtanam Vishnu Jagan Mangalamam Hasam Mahatam apikauravya vidhyaikantika nishkritam. So this chanting of the holy name is the most purest activity in the universe, and it's auspicious for everyone. And nishkritam, the word nishkritam means it eradicates all sinful activities. So I would now invite all of you to join in this kirtan. We should all sing together for everyone's purification. So let's purify this entire atmosphere with the Hare Krishna Mahamantra.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare
Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Everybody. Hare Krishna. So there was Gaur Gopal. He was giving his Mayavadi talk, non-Krishna, not don't touch Krishna at all. It looked like he had about 200 people or so, maybe 300, I don't know. That's what he is doing. He never did any kirtan. There's no way he did any kirtan there. Today morning, as you saw, we did the kirtan. This is the real Prabhupada following. We have to keep to the standards. We cannot simply water down the standards just to please the public. But this is what the trap he has fallen into, Gaur Gopal's book. It's just simply hodgepodge stuff. We are distributing Prabhupada's books here. We had kirtan. We had a small explanation about the Harinam. This is Prabhupada's preaching, you know? Not simply some nonsense stuff. What is the use of a grand arrangement of things if it is not pure? Even a drop of purity is better than an ocean of poison. I don't say I'm pure or we are pure. By executing the order of the spiritual master, Srila Prabhupada, we become pure. The purity is because of the strength of the order of the spiritual master. Well, I'm escaping from the office so that I can actually record this without disturbing them. You know where I'm heading to? The storeroom. Alright, so, as I was editing the video, I thought I would touch upon some points which I might have missed out. So here they are. So firstly, I was literally asked by somebody to whom I expressed my displeasure in the way Gaur Gopal Das preaches. So that person said to me, who are you even to comment on him? You know, he is such a big influencer, a guru of sorts. And who are you? You are a nobody compared to him. See, the point is, wealth, following, these are not the things that define a person. What he does is what defines him. I mean, if fame is the index of success, then you can get famous with anything. And for some, it's just making prank videos. What is the value that you're bringing to the people that you're connecting with? A devotee means he who preaches Krishna consciousness in its pristine, pure form so that the masses may be benefited. But if you see Gaur Gopal Das's speeches, I want to ask you to show me where he mentions Krishna. This is exactly the point. So he may be famous, he may be, you know, influencing so many people, but if you observe, many people come to his talks or watch him on the internet just for entertainment, jokes. That's why I think, as my brother says always, he could have been an honest stand-up comedian or a motivational speaker, maybe. But when he dons those robes of a devotee, a Hare Krishna devotee, then he's crossing lines. He is wearing in one way and is speaking in another way. That's a disconnect. If you're wearing like this, like a Hare Krishna devotee, then you have to speak as Srila Prabhupada has taught us. Srila Prabhupada said, there should be no compromise in the preaching. Srila Prabhupada's letter to Giriraj Swami, 3rd January 1972. My dear Giriraj, the fact is that I'm the only one in India who is openly criticizing everything that falls short of complete surrender to Krishna. My Guru Maharaj never compromised in his preaching, nor will I, nor should any of my students. Your ever well wisher, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami. And he is compromising so much that there is no mention of Krishna in his talks. So what are you trying to do? I just want to add a quick interesting incident that happened during his talk here in Singapore, which I almost forgot. One of our devotees, Vishwambhar Prabhu, he got a free pass to attend Gaur Gopal Das's talk. And so he just went to see how, you know, he speaks, just to check him out. So he was just sitting in the audience and he was feeling so disgusted. I mean, not only was there no mention of Krishna, but even the jokes were very stale. Nobody was even laughing, you know, and everything was mundane. And then suddenly, out of nowhere, Gaur Gopal Das said this. It went something like this. If anyone disturbs your peace, something like that, then I have one very powerful mantra which will help you in any situation. Then Vishwambhar Prabhu was like, wow, is he going to actually mention the Hare Krishna mantra? So he was excited. He just, like, you know, sat straight on his seat. And he says the mantra is this. Om Ignoraya Namaha. Just ignore the problem. This is the kind of preaching. I mean, how difficult is it to say the Maha Mantra? Look at the compromise. Just look at the compromise. That's what I'm talking about. There's this feeling, you know, that if I mention Krishna, maybe many people will just, you know, think it's too cultish and they would run away and not hear me. This is the fear. The idea is to please the masses than to please Krishna. That's the disease of jana. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, na dhanam, na janam, na sundarim. I don't want following, I don't want wealth, I don't want beautiful women. I just want to be your eternal servant. That has been Srila Prabhupada's way of preaching as well. So we should follow that as his disciples, as his followers. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, the guru of Srila Prabhupada, you know, when his disciples wrote articles for his magazine, he would just see whether there is the name of Krishna mentioned in the article. If there are many times the name Krishna is mentioned in the article, that's it. It would get published. So if you put that criterion in his talks, he gets 0 points. Zero. That's what I'm talking about. He wouldn't even qualify. So our whole idea is to bring people to Krishna. But if you're going to do something and, you know, amass a lot of following and then you're not herding them to Krishna consciousness, then what are you doing? You're simply cheating them in the way of good, positive vibes without any substance in it. Tell them, surrender to Krishna and all your problems will be solved. You know, he says things like, oh, if there is a solution to a problem, then why worry? If there is no solution to a problem, then why worry? Anyway, it can't be solved. This is not the way we solve problems. These things can be good sound bites, but they're not practical reality. They cannot be applied. So Krishna gives the answer on how to overcome our anxiety, our miseries. It is to become Krishna conscious. We will not be shattered. We will not be even shaken. We will not even flinch. That's the consciousness we have to come to. Like the Pandavas, the whole life was full of challenges. Their devotion to Krishna never flinched. In fact, it kept on increasing. The problems in life are because of lack of Krishna consciousness, because of disobedience to Krishna. So to rectify the situation, one has to surrender to Krishna back. That's it. And then all our problems are solved. That's a simple answer. And this book, Life's Amazing Secrets, nothing amazing about this book. This is a waste of paper. Literally a waste of paper.
You don't believe me?
Srimad Bhagavatam confirms it.
Nayadvachas chitra padam harerya jagat pavitram pragranita karhichit tadvayasam tirthamushanti manasa nayatraham shaniramantu sikshayah.
Those words which do not describe the glories of the Lord, who alone can sanctify the atmosphere of the whole universe, are considered by saintly persons to be like unto a place of pilgrimage for crows, aka garbage. Since the all perfect persons are inhabitants of the transcendental abode, they do not derive any pleasure there. Nothing about Krishna, nothing about... He does mention a little bit about Krishna and Arjuna and the Bhagavad Gita, but he just screws out his own meaning out of it. So nothing the way a Krishna devotee, as a follower of Srila Prabhupada, should be mentioning or should be talking. That's what I'm saying. Alright, so if you like this video, you know what to do. Press the like button, comment something in the YouTube comment section below here. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so. So with that, I'll sign off and see you in the next one. Hare Krishna.
We cannot make any compromise in the whole point.